हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, माई सेल्फ डॉक्टर पल्लवी राय, एसोसिएट प्रोफेसर एंड एचओडी फार्माकोग्नोसी, रामेश इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ वोकेशनल एंड टेक्निकल एजुकेशन. टुडे आई एम हियर टू डिस्कस ऑन द टॉपिक ऑफ टैनन्स, विच इज अ टॉपिक गिवन इन योर यूनिट 4 ऑफ सिलेबस PP 405T. सो लेट्स बिगिन विद द टॉपिक ऑफ टैनन्स. Tannins are basically the products which are produced in plants as a result of any kind of secondary metabolism. So they are basically organic compounds which have a very complex structure, and the main phenomena which is observed in tannins is that they are non-nitrogenous substances. Non-nitrogenous means they will not have any kind of nitrogen moiety present. They are polyphenolic substances. Polyphenolic substances means that there is a benzene ring with multiple hydroxy groups. It's not just one hydroxy group, but multiple hydroxy groups are present on the benzene ring. And one more characteristic which is very important is that they are very high molecular compounds, and they are reproduced as a result of secondary metabolism. The main medicinal use is that it is used as an antiseptic, and in various GIT diseases like any kind of diarrhea, dysentery, where a lot of water loss is taking place from the body. It other industrial application where it is used to a great extent is in the leather industry. Now here it will become clear to you that in leather industry, the animal skin is generally processed with these tannin solutions in order to make them more colored or have a dark coloration and have a mainly shiny appearance, as you can see in the leather which you normally use. Now this tannin term was given by a scientist Seguin in 1796, which mainly showed that the substances which have the ability to color the animal hide. Animal hide means the animal skin, which was main purpose for which it was found was to produce leather from the animal skin. So now let's discuss certain examples of the drugs which contain tannins. The first drug which I have shown is the Ashoka. Ashoka, as you know, is basically Ashoka tree is very well known drug, and it is mainly used for the female reproductive organs, mainly the uterus health. Then we have the Baheda fruit. Baheda fruit is also known as Myrobalan, and it is one of the important constituent of Triphala Churna. Again, another important constituent of Triphala Churna is Amla fruit, and Amla fruit is a very well-known drug. We all know the uses for it in respect to the digestive system, as well as the skin, as well as the hairs, etc. Then we have the pale katechu. Pale katechu as well as the black katechu. There are two types of katechus. In Hindi, we call them katha, which you know. It is generally applied on the betel leaves, which people use traditionally. But the main function is that it is astringent in nature. Astringent means it is protein precipitating in nature. And secondly, that it is very good for retaining the water in body or to avoid any kind of dehydration due to diarrhea or dysentery-like conditions. Then there is an example of tea. Tea we normally consume on a regular basis, though the main effect which we have, the CNS stimulant effect, is due to the alkaloids present in tea, but the color which is shown in tea is due to the tannins. Then the Arjuna bark. Arjuna bark is a very important drug because it is a cardiotonic drug, and you must have heard of a very important formulation, that is Arjuna Rishtha, which is produced from this Arjuna bark. And then lastly, we have the cloves. Cloves are rich source of volatile oils, but the color which is there in clove is due to the tannins solutions. Tannins in water form a colloidal solution. You very well know what is a colloidal solution. So they are dispersed in the water in a colloidal form, and in general the tannins in solid form are non-crystalline. They may be amorphous or powdery material, but they are non-crystalline, and they always have a color which varies from pale yellow to light brown red color. And the solubility property, if we discuss, as we already saw, it is highly soluble in water and alcohol, but it is insoluble in the organic solvents except for acetone. So it is soluble in water, alcohol and acetone, but it is insoluble completely in other organic solvents like chloroform, ethyl acetate or petroleum ether, the non-polar solvents. The molecular weight of tannins is very high, as we discussed in the definition, and it varies from 500 to 20,000. So it is very high molecular weight. And the main property of tannins is that it normally binds with proteins and forms insoluble or soluble tannin protein complexes. This property is also called as the astringent property of the tannins, and normally it is seen that the solution of tannins are slightly acidic in nature and they also have an astringent taste. Now, astringent taste here you can identify directly with the amla fruit, which you must have consumed, and you have a tingling sensation on the tongue. Or even when we eat pineapple, there is a tingling sensation on the tongue, which is due to the tannin, which is due to the astringent like effect. What are the main uses of tannins? So if we look at the medicinal uses, they are generally antidote because they precipitate any compound containing nitrogen or certain metallic components which may be poisonous in nature. And they are also antiseptic in nature, antiseptic because they precipitate any kind of microorganism which is present in the body, so acting like a antiseptic through the astringent effect. And the same precipitating effect can be used as an anti-carcinogenic agent also because it precipitates the carcinogenic agents present in the body. Now, the biological activities which have been proven by scientific studies say that they inhibit the lipid peroxidation, which is mainly responsible for the generation of the free radicals in our body, or the ROS in our body. And these ROS or free radicals normally produce, you can say, ill health of the vital organs like liver, kidney, brain, etc. It has been also proved that it decreases the blood urea nitrogen content in our body. Blood urea nitrogen content in higher concentration is a sign of toxicity. So when tannins are taken, this normally decrease in concentration in the blood. It also inhibits the plasmin and leads to lipolysis in fat cells. So all these things have been proven already by scientific studies. The other industrial uses where it is used is mainly, one is the leather industry, then we have the ink manufacture, vegetable tanning, as well as preservatives. So now we move to the next important topic in tannins, that is classification of tannins. So let us have a look. Tannins are first of all categorized as true tannins and pseudo tannins, and further they are categorized, the true tannins, they are categorized as hydrolyzable tannins, condensed tannins, and complex tannins. Now we will move further and discuss each of these in detail. What are true tannins? True tannins are basically polyhydroxyphenolic compounds which have the ability to convert the animal skin into leather. They generally give a positive gold beater's test, which we'll be discussing further. The molecular weight of true tannins ranges from 1000 to 5000. However, the pseudo tannins, they are similar to tannins in many features, but when we react this to animal hide, they normally do not convert it into leather, and therefore they give a negative gold beater's test. Here there are two structures, as you can see. One is the ellagic acid structure, which is a true tannin, and we have a chlorogenic acid, which is a pseudo tannin. Ellagic acid is normally found in substances like amla, while pseudo tannin is normally found in substances like tea, which normally doesn't give color to our skin. Now, what is gold beater test? The gold beater test is generally done to check the ability of the tannin to react with the skin proteins. And here we use the animal hide, or animal skin. Sometimes the powder of the skin can also be used. In the general test, the official procedure says that we have to use the intestine of ox, and then we have to soak it in 20% solution of hydrochloric acid, after which we will dip it again in distilled water for washing or removing the hydrochloric acid. Now the skin which we have, that is dipped again with a tannin solution, and after dipping it in tannin solution for 5 minutes, it is removed and washed again. Now just imagine that whatever tannins are there, they have reacted with the proteins present on the skin and they have tried to precipitate it. So there is a complex of tannins and proteins on the skin which is present. Now in the last step, what we do is we dip this skin in ferrous sulfate solution. So if it is a true tannin, means it has the ability to precipitate the proteins on the skin, the color which is developed is brown or black color. In case it is a pseudo tannin, then there will not be any complex formation of the skin proteins and the tannins, and there will be no change in the color. So this is the gold beater test. Sometimes if we do not have the animal skin or the intestine, the powder of animal hide is also available, and that can be used for performing the test in the same pattern. Now we move to the next classification of true tannins, where we saw the first categories of the hydrolyzable tannins. Now what are hydrolyzable tannins? Basically, if we do dry distillation of a particular tannin mixture, then on heating it gets broken down or hydrolyzed due to the presence of acids or enzymes into smaller types of polyphenolic compounds. The two main types of polyphenolic compounds which are formed after hydrolysis are gallic acid and ellagic acid. So gallic acid, basically it has a benzene ring attached to a carboxylic acid along with three hydroxy group, and ellagic acid is formed by the condensation of two gallic acid structures. The gallic acid, if a compound on hydrolysis produces gallic acid, then it is known as gallitannin, and if it is producing substance mainly ellagic acid on hydrolysis, then it is known as ellagitannin. The gallic acid is found in rhubarb, clove, and ellagic acid is found mainly in eucalyptus leaves, myrobalans like baheda and harde, and it is also found in pomegranate bark. The test which is done, basically, as you can see, that the test done is when we have gallic acid and ellagic acid and it is reacted with any iron salt, be it FeCl3 or ferrous sulfate, then it produces blue fluorescence. And as the reaction is also again showing that hydrolyzable tannins on dry distillation normally produce pyrogallols plus phenolic compounds. So they break down and hydrolyze to produce further different types of polyphenolic compounds. So that is basically hydrolyzable tannins, and as discussed already that there are two types of hydrolyzable tannins. Gallitannins are those which produce gallic acid on hydrolysis, and ellagitannins are those which produce ellagic acid on hydrolysis. These are the properties of gallitannins and ellagitannins. The occurrence, as we already discussed, on hydrolysis, gallitannins produce gallic acid and ellagitannins produce ellagic acid. The property of gallitannins are that they are rapidly soluble in water, and free gallic acid is present in the plants as it get and it is converted to glucogallitannins. It reacts with glucose to form glucogallitannins. While ellagitannins, they are slowly soluble in water and they are present in plants in open and ring forms as hexahydroxydiphenic acid. Now we move to the next category, that is the condensed tannins. Condensed tannins are those tannins which on dry distillation, again on heating, they do not hydrolyze but they decompose to produce certain compounds which are known as the flavophenes. On dry distillation, the condensed tannins produce catechol, which are a type of a flavophenes, and these tannins are also known as catechol tannins. So the catechu or flavanols or flavan-3,4-diols, they generally come to this category of the condensed tannins. The examples of condensed tannins are cinchona bark, male fern, areca seeds, tea leaves, wild cherry bark, even some of the constituents of baheda fruit and amla fruit. So both are there. Hydrolyzable tannins and condensed tannins are present in baheda fruits and amla fruits. And the test to confirm this is done by reacting the catechol solutions with iron salts, same as the hydrolyzable tannins like FeCl3 and FeSO4. And the result is that the condensed tannins, they generally give green fluorescence on reaction with iron salts. So again, I will repeat that the condensed tannins on dry distillation, they produce certain catechol tannins which are known as flavophenes, which are generally the decomposed material, which are generally insoluble red colored decomposed mass, and it is not a particular a tannin or a tannin like substance. It is something else which is known as a flavophene, and the examples for this is hemamelis, cinchona and cinnamon. Now we will move to the next category, that is the complex tannins. Complex tannin is basically a mixture of both hydrolyzable tannin and condensed tannins. And as you can see the structure which has been shown, that there are many different types of polyphenolic compounds which are joined together and a complex structure is formed. So they are basically defined as tannins in which a catechin unit is bound glycosidically, just like a glycoside, to either a gallotannin or a ellagitannin unit. As the name implies, the structure of these compounds is very, very complex. And the example of the structure which I have shown is acutisimicin. This is basically a complex. Now, what are the chemical tests? So, we have already discussed the Goldbitter test in detail because it is an important parameter for classification of true tannins and pseudotannins. Now, we will move to the other tests which are important in tannins, and first test is the gelatin test. So, here if we take the tannin solution and add aqueous solution of gelatin and sodium chloride, a buff colored precipitate is formed. If we do the second test, that is phenazone test, where we take a mixture of aqueous extract of the drug and sodium acid phosphate and then heat, cool and filter it. So, a solution of phenazone is added to this filtrate, a bulky colored precipitate is formed. The third test, which is very important, also known as the Cutachin test, which is mainly done for the condensed tannins. Here we take a matchstick, first we dip it in the plant extract whichever we want to test, and then we will dry it near a burner. We don't have to burn the matchstick, but we have to dry it, and then after drying again we will moisten it with HCl. Concentrated HCl has to be used. Again, we have to warm it. We don't have to burn the matchstick. We have to warm it. And once the heat is produced, the matchstick turns into a pink color due to the generation of fluoroglycinol. The HCl and a fluoroglycinol structure which is formed due to the tannins present, the matchstick takes a red color. Remember, the matchstick is having lignin which is present in the wood, the lignin as well as the fluoroglycinol produced by the tannins and HCl together gives a red coloration. Now the other chemical test, that is chlorogenic acid test. Here we will take the extract of chlorogenic acid, which is a pseudo tannin. It is not a true tannin, remember. And then we will add aqueous ammonia. A green color is produced on exposure of air. Means there is a gradual development of green color whenever a chlorogenic acid is tested. Then we have the vanillin hydrochloric acid test. In this test, we take a sample solution, add vanillin hydrochloride reagent, and then a pink color appears showing the formation of fluoroglycinol. So now we move to the next topic, that is isolation of tannins. The isolation of tannins is a very tedious job and it has to be performed very meticulously. But whenever we isolate any chemical constituent, the solubility plays a very important role. And as we discussed that both hydrolyzable and condensed tannins are highly soluble in water and alcohol, but insoluble in organic solvents like solvent ether, chloroform and benzene. So what is done is basically first we take our drug and then we add either the saturated mixture of water, alcohol along with ether. So whatever ingredients that are soluble in ether are removed and whatever ingredients are soluble in water, they come in one particular extract. So all our gallic acid, ellagic acid and other tannins, they are extracted in the water layer, while the etheral layers takes away the other heavy, the non-polar components which are present. Now what is done is after that, in a separating funnel, we can separate the ether layer as well as the aqueous layer. And the aqueous layer which we collect, that can be concentrated, dried, and further we have to use different specialized techniques like chromatography and other separation techniques to separate our main tannin compound. So that is a very tedious job. So thank you very much for listening to this lecture. We have covered basically the definition, classification, properties, chemical test and isolation of tannins. Thank you very much for listening.